The Jersey Shore Area School District is going high tech. It recently announced a collaboration with the Pennsylvania Department of Education to help resolve some connectivity issues plaguing large portions of the district. Eyewitness News reporter Sean Coffey joins us from the district administration building with more tonight. Sean.
Candace, good evening. Jersey Shore now one of just 17 districts in the Commonwealth that's been chosen to participate in what's known as Connected to Learn. It's a statewide initiative meant to increase access to education and provide new resources to students in remote learning. Through a partnership with the Pennsylvania Department of Education, Jersey Shore Area School District has announced sweeping changes to the resources available for students lacking access to reliable internet and digital connectivity. Superintendent Dr. Brian Ulmer says historically the district's size and rugged geography have made these resources impossible to provide.
The valleys and the mountains that across the Jersey Shore Area School District prohibit things like cell phone towers or running broadband internet.
The plan to provide a workaround for these deficiencies in infrastructure across the Commonwealth. It includes $15 million to expand inventory of assistive technology like tablets and hotspots, as well as targeted expansion of internet access to areas identified as most in need. Plus, a collaboration with PBS Pennsylvania to begin what's called data casting, the use of over-the-air TV signals to deliver educational content that can be used on computers without the internet.
With a receiver in your home, you could get packets of information, educational programming, things for kids to do if we're pushed into a remote setting.
Ulmer says it's not just students who will benefit from the initiative.
Even our teachers, depending on where they live in the district, they can't go home and get on their district device and do work, even if they want to.
Kurt Jones is one of those teachers. As a faculty member and father of three students in the district, Jones says his family's own struggles to connect prove this program will be essential.
It's not a want, it's a need, and I think that it's just wonderful that we are able to get these resources in order to be able to move forward and make sure that we are providing the best education possible, given these special circumstances.
Now, another thing both Ulmer and Jones mentioned to me is that they hope this program will help offset some of the inequities exposed both by the pandemic and by the remote learning model. Obviously, not all students fortunate enough to have the same access to those essential tools. They also told me it'll give the district some increased flexibility should they be forced back into a remote learning situation. In Jersey Shore, Sean Coffey, Eyewitness News.